Time for Us, the beautiful music from Romeo and Juliet, composed by Nino Rota, who left us many wonderful pieces for movies. We're going to play an arrangement in E minor of this piece that I believe is very, very guitaristic. You could be as romantic and mellow as you want with this piece, and it will not fail you. Now, the piece in a way is simple, but in a way is also complex, like almost everything in life, right? For the right hand, it'll play slow passages, so the right hand will not have problems hitting the notes as long as you practice enough. But it's not just hitting the notes that you need with this piece. You gotta make those notes sound clear. The melody has to ring and sing. And that's what is challenging, because these are long notes since the piece is slow. And in this case, for long notes, it's more important to have good quality of sound than for notes that go fast. Now, that's about the right hand. About the left hand, what you will see is some challenging bars, some challenging stretches, and because the piece is slow, while you do those stretches, you will have to hold them, and your left hand will work very hard trying to make that happen. And I would expect that if you have not played the piece before, or if you are not playing guitar, have not been playing guitar for a long time, you will have some problems with those stretches and with those bars. But, as I highlighted before, what is interesting about the left hand is that positions that seem impossible to reach or to hold when you try to play them first, after a week, they seem to be a little more possible. 2 weeks pass, and then all of a sudden you find yourself, oh boy, it is sounding now. How come these notes that I couldn't make sound clearly are sounding now? And that's what happens with the left hand. It's like a miracle. Little by little, you get it. With the right hand, sometimes the problems are more difficult to address. But with the left hand, it goes more or less in the sequence that I explained. So there's a challenge for the left hand here. And the challenge for the right hand is mainly hitting your notes clean and make it sound with passion, with art, which in the end is our goal when we play this kind of piece. So a time for us, for Nino Rota. I'm sure you'll have a lot of fun playing this piece. Send us your feedback. Thank you. Let's cover the right hand technique for playing the theme from Romeo and Juliet. This is a romantic piece that is played in a slow tempo. And pieces like that offer the challenge of being able to know to play the notes clearly. They have to ring to your ears. And also these notes have to be sustained for as long as they are supposed to last, which is not always easy. Let's cover the left-hand technique for playing Romeo and Juliet. Now this piece is quite demanding on the left hand. It doesn't look like, but because it is slow and because it has some stretches and because it requires that you sustain the notes for as long as they are supposed to last, and this is a slow piece, then it becomes an interesting and hard challenge at times. One thing I found about the left hand is that when you learn a piece and you find new chords that are a challenge for your hand, your left hand perhaps will be unable to do that. No matter how long have you been playing the guitar, there are still some challenges there. And then you keep playing that, maybe after a week you notice, oh boy, I'm doing it now, but still it requires a lot of effort, and still there are a couple of notes that need to sound better. And then after 2 weeks or so, you start realizing, boy, it's coming across, now I'm playing it without much effort. So that's how playing pieces evolves for the left hand, when you have to do challenging positions.